the story that comes with it is 100% true. In fact, it's been watered down a bit, because the actual full story is ridiculous. Now, for this, I do require a chair, so Skip, are you there? You've got a chair, then? Brilliant, thank you so much. Just put down there, so thank you, Skip. So, let's see, just a couple of inches to the right. That's brilliant, thank you. And just back, just a fraction of that, 6 inches. That's brilliant, thanks so much. Cheers. Well, 1985 was a pivotal year in my life. It was a pivotal year in my life because it was my last year of drinking, because I was told if I carried on drinking, I'd die. And I thought, I quite like it here. I like playing music, I like people, so I'll stop drinking. So that's all that. So I did. So 1985 was the last year that I imbibed, and I was good. Cool, I was good. Anyway, when I was not working, my Saturdays were sacrosanct. What I did on the Saturday, I would go down to the golf club in the morning and have a round of golf with my mates. I'd then come back to Cambly Town, which is where I lived in Cambly, and I would go to a little Italian restaurant and have a nice little meal. Then I would go down to Cambly Town Football Club, where I was the chairman, and I would watch them lose. They lost every single week without fail. But that was my Saturdays, and then in the evening I'd go out with my mates. Well, this particular Saturday, it started off about April 1985, and I went down to the golf club, had a nice round of golf, came back into Cambly, and for reasons that I still don't know to this day, the Italian restaurant was closed. And I was really hungry. The only thing that was open was a very, very dodgy Indian restaurant. It was known to be dodgy, and even the dogs walked 3 streets by to get past it. I was so hungry, I thought, I've got to eat something. So I went in there, and I ordered a vindaloo curry, which is a really hot one, and I'm eating it, and my stomach's sending me telepathic messages going, please don't do this. And I'm sure most of you must have had a meal at some time when you're eating, going, I'm going to regret eating this. This was one of those. And I ate it, went down to the football club, watched us lose, and at the end of the game, you always had to entertain, because I was chairman, I had to entertain the chairman of the opposing side. So we were in the boardroom, and he's there with his other directors, and I said, oh, congratulations on your win. And he said, oh, thank you, Rick. He said, I thought our ninth goal was a little lucky. And at that moment, I had a huge gripe pain in my stomach. And he said, are you all right? I said, no. I said, I've had a really dodgy curry and it's going through me like a Ferrari. I'm in real trouble here. And he said, well, do you want to go and use the toilets? I said, not here, not at the football club. I said, this is a proper job. This is go home, sit down, newspaper, everything. This is good. And I went, okay, Rick, thank you. So I said, okay, help yourself some more drink. And I went, I've got in my car. I only lived a mile from the ground. And I'm going up the main road, which was a 30-mile-an-hour limit. And I'm in a line of traffic, we're all doing 35, so I don't think anything about it. And there's a policeman on the call with a radar gun. He lets everybody go except for me. You, in, bugger. So I go, I pull into this cul-de-sac thing, there's about 6 houses there. And he wasn't a local policeman, because I knew all the local policemen. I went down the window and he said, have you been down Cambly Town Football Club? I said, yeah. He said, have you had a drink? I said, I've had one brandy and one beer. He said, well, you admitted having a drink, I'm going to give you an alcohol breath test. I said, okay, fine. So he gives me an alcohol breath test. He said, you failed by 1 point. He said, well, you failed. You're under arrest. I'm waiting for a car to come and pick us up and take us to the police station. No, I can't believe it. So I'm standing there, and at that moment, the old gripe pain in me going, he said, are you all right? I said, no. And I said, I've just had a really dodgy curry. And I said, and it wants to come out. I said, can we walk to the police station? It's only time to do. I don't know where it is. He went, no. I said, well, can I go into somebody's house and use their toilet? I said, I'm in real trouble here. He went, no. At that moment, another police motorbike pulled up, and a guy called Murray, who was a mate of mine. He said, anything wrong, Rick? I said, no. I said, I've just failed the breath test. But at one point, he went, well, it doesn't matter, you failed, that's it. I said, I know, don't worry. I said, the one problem I've got, I said, I've had a really dodgy curry. He said, you've not been to the Raj, have you? Well, yeah. He said, we're closing that down next week. I said, it's closing me down at the moment. And I said, that nasty, that horrible policeman, he said, he's not one of ours, he's from another district. I said, well, he won't let me walk to the police station, he won't let me lose somebody's house, and I'm in real trouble, and you know, I don't know what to do. He said, leave it with me. So he went over and talked to this policeman, who came back and put me in an arm lock. And he marched me across the road to this doorstep where this woman was standing. And he said, madam, do you have a downstairs toilet? She went, yes. He said, I'm commandeering it for the use of my prisoner. So we walk in, she's like, there it is, in there. So he said, you stand there, son, don't you go anywhere. So he goes in and inspects the toilet. I don't know what you thought I was going to do, try and hide around the U-boat or something. So he basically comes in and goes, all right, son, in you go. So I went in and I shut the door, and he puts his big boot in the door, size 14, and says, you're not shutting the door, son. I said, you've got no idea what's coming, have you? So I go and I take my trousers off and I sit on the limit and I'm thinking, this is bloody ridiculous. I've been done for driving over the limit. I'm in my best suit, sitting on the stranger's toilet. Having been arrested and there's a policeman's size 14 boot in the door. Nothing else could possibly happen. And at that precise moment, through the gap in the door, came my Journey to the Centre of the Earth album cover. Jeffrey, I'm sitting on your mum's toilet.